The Philippine government is set to identify businesses that can resume at limited capacity as it begins to ease pandemic lockdowns. With us now for more is Marivic Espanyo, chairperson and CEO of PNA Grant Thornton. Good to see you, Marivic. Welcome to the program.
Hello, good morning, Kathy.
So what do you make of the president's decision of a modified enhanced community quarantine in Metro Manila, Laguna, and Cebu City?
Well, I think it is a good move. We need to really calibrate the opening of businesses as we prepare for the more general and broader GCQ.
Do you think we're ready? I mean, from the business sector's point of view and the preparations you've been doing towards this end?
Well, we are trying to get ready. In fact, as early as April, most businesses have been discussing within their own organizations how to prepare, and we're trying to learn from each other on the possible best practices that we can, you know, we can implement. So important for us would be the safety of our people, making sure that they can go to the office, to our offices, and be assured that we have the hygienic practices in place. We want to make sure likewise that transportation as well as other, you know, client needs will be well prepared to be serviced.
Yeah, and select enterprises are going to be allowed to operate at half capacity from May 16th, and MSMEs are going to be a key focus here as they've been hardest hit. So where do they start? How do they even get out of the gate just managing the cash flows?
Okay, well, at this point, it is really important for most businesses, especially the MSMEs, to really study where they are in terms of liquidity. So cash flows coming from, you know, from their sales, if they're still able to operate at this point, receivables from clients, their credit lines, they have to be talking with their banks to assess whether they would be able to still tap the credit, you know, the available lines that they have previously discussed with the banks. It is also important for them to really analyze their operations, identify what would be the critical, you know, expenses that they have to give priority to, review, you know, the relationships that they have with their suppliers to check whether there's a possibility of, you know, deferring some of the payments or coming up with a payment schedule. They have to look at contracts, for instance. They cannot just arbitrarily decide not to pay certain suppliers or certain, I guess, fixed expenses, because this may entail significant penalties on their part. So from a cash flow perspective, I think they really need to look at both their customer side and their relationship with their suppliers.
Yeah, the customer side is a little bit difficult because, I mean, how do you stabilize and boost sales when consumer demand isn't there yet, but for the basic needs and essentials coming off a lockdown?
Well, I think for some companies, they are still able to, you know, deliver certain goods or services. I think it is at this time, it is critical for companies or enterprises to exercise some agility. You can see that most of them were able to adapt quickly by embracing technology, partnering with available suppliers or vendors for it. But definitely, I totally agree with that, the sales has gone down. And at this point, I would suggest to enterprises to really review the relationship and, you know, what they expect moving forward, even if the GCQ is already here. They have to understand where the clients are. Are they having financial difficulties as well? They should know whether they can expect the payments that they hope they would be able to collect.
And re-engage as well with the staff, the workers. When you talk about the enterprises, just keeping staff employed is going to be a struggle in the interim. So how do enterprises manage to keep their workforce when letting go appears to be the path of least resistance?
Well, I think for most companies, they need to understand that their objective would be to sustain the business. I know it is difficult, but you know, I've heard some businesses that remain to be optimistic. They will look for ways on, you know, how they can adapt to the new norm. So it is important that that you have the right people and that you have the right training for them. So if, let's say, the new norm would require more sales or interaction with customers online, then we need to train our people how to do it. Definitely, there would be pressure to scale down, to probably put some workers on leave right now. But I'd like to believe that it is temporary.
In a situation where the phased easing of restrictions will take place in the next couple of weeks and months, how do MSMEs manage procurement and an already disrupted supply chain?
Well, I think most of them are really reaching out to the organizations that they are part of, listening and asking their friends, their colleagues in the industry, where the possible suppliers can be. I think in this part, government can play an important role. We in MAP, for instance, of which I'm a member, we've been talking a lot about supply chain. And there is really a challenge right now to know who can be the potential suppliers are. So if we can, we've been talking about gathering the data and sharing this with the public, so access to supply can be easier.
And just picking up on your point about digital transformation, is that a must for all MSMEs post-COVID, or is it something they can merely consider at this point?
Well, I think at this time, people are saying that the virus will still be there, even if we do lift the ECQ. And therefore, we can expect that social distancing would still be observed. People would still be worried, to go out in the malls or places where there are a lot of people. So to be able to cope up with this, I think businesses at this point must really look at how they can embrace and use technology, the existing technology, to change their operating models.
Just a final point, communicating with stakeholders, very important as we re-engage society. So what do MSMEs tell them?
Well, SMEs are really trying to tell their clients that they are in business. But at the same time, they must be transparent on, the challenges that they face. So it is important, for instance, for them to assess the level of production that they have, the ability to access the raw materials, and match this with their capability to supply the needs of their customers. I think at this particular time, it is important that they engage this conversation in a transparent way so that, everybody would be able to meet their own needs.
Right, it's a bit of a laundry list of homework for all the businesses out there as we re-engage into business. But thank you for the direction there, Marivic, and keep well. Appreciate the information. Marivic Espano of PNA Grant Thornton.